Betsy DeVos has been confirmed as the next Secretary of Education. It was a 50-50 tie. Lisa Murkowski and Susan Collins, those two Republican senators, voted against her nomination. Vice President Mike Pence, whom you see there, President of the Senate, casting the tie-breaking vote. Again, Betsy DeVos has been confirmed to be Donald Trump's next Secretary of Education. I want to bring in now Kevin Cirilli. He is our chief Washington correspondent on Capitol Hill. He joins us now. And Kevin, give us a little bit of the backstory here. We sort of assumed here we'd get to this point. When did we learn that Lisa Murkowski and Susan Collins were going to come out against the nominee here, now the Secretary Betsy DeVos?
Last week, and of course, this sent shockwaves amongst this administration, which had thought that it would be able to whip Republicans together in order to secure all of President Trump's cabinet appointee picks. I can tell you that this is a win for the Republican Senate whip operation. This is a win for people like Paul Teller, the former Senator Cruz staffer turned administration congressional liaison official who has been working tirelessly with Vice President Mike Pence's political operation to maintain the votes in the Senate to secure what would have been an embarrassing blemish on behalf of the administration as it looks to take advantage of the Republican majority in the upper chamber, but also to move their picks. There were no surprises today. While Senator Murkowski and Senator Collins did buck party line, there were no last-minute senators in the Republican Party who voted against them. This is a win again for the Republican Senate whip operation.
Yeah, Kevin, this was definitely one of the nominations that looked like it was going to get the most opposition. Does this mean now that we have a confirmed vote and an education secretary, that all of the other nominees will get confirmed?
Bonnie, there was a lot of noise with this nomination, and that noise reverberated, especially as criticism has mounted against the White House, particularly following President Trump's executive orders regarding a temporary travel ban. Of course, that court decision and the circuit court expected later today. But with regards to the other nominations, I can tell you that the other nominations that are in the works for the next couple of days and weeks include Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin. Of course, there will be a hearing on his nomination expected to be this weekend. I can also tell you that, again, the Republicans feel confident that they will now be able to move all of President Trump's remaining cabinet picks. This was the toughest. This did present a political headache, but so far they were able to clear that hurdle.